Hello students, welcome back to the online classes. Today I am going to teach lesson 9, Fagin and his voice revision. So up to lesson 8 I have finished the revision. Today I am going to take lesson number 9. Now this story of Fagin and his voice is about the Oliver Twist, and we know that this is a novel written by Charles Dickens. Okay, Charles Dickens had written this novel, and in this novel we see that Oliver Twist was an orphan. His mother died soon after his birth, and he lived in a workhouse in a parish where he was working very, very hard. He was given less food and made him to work very hard, and Mr. Bumble was very strict, and he used to ill-treat him. So when he grew up and he was no more want to work here, he ran away from there. He walked almost 70 miles. Okay, 70 miles he walked, and he did not have much things in his hand. He was just having just two pairs of stockings, that is socks, long socks, then a shirt, and just one single penny, maybe 1 rupee, nothing more than that. He just walked to London, and he wanted to go to London, and he was thinking that when he will reach in London, Mr. Bumble will never be able to catch him. He will never be able to find him there, because it is a very big city. Now, after traveling for 70 miles, whenever he used to feel hungry or wanted food, something, he used to knock at different cottages and used to get something, whatever leftover was there. He used to be happy with that. He used to sleep on the roadside with the grass on the grass and all. Like that, he spent time and almost reached to London. So when he reached London, he happened to meet a boy called Jack Dodger. Now he is a bit lame, his leg is a bit lame, and he was wearing a big pant and a shirt and a very huge coat which was going almost below his knee, and a hat which was almost falling down. Now the Dodger, when he saw Oliver, he asked, "Hello friend, from where you are coming, where are you going? Are you hungry and all those?" And he said, "Yes, I am hungry. I need food." So the Dodger said, "Okay, you wait here. I will get food for you." And he went and bought a jam bottle, some bread and all, and gave to him. Okay, have it. Oliver had this food after 7 days. Imagine such stomach full of food, breakfast he had that day after 7 days. Dodger asked, "Where are you going?" And he said that, "I am going to London." Then again the Dodger asked that, "In London, where will you stay? Do you have any money?" And Oliver told that, I do not have any place, and even I do not have money." Then Dodger said, "Okay, don't worry. I know a very kind gentleman in London, and he will give you home as well as food to eat. So you come with me." So he took him to a place, a dirty place it was, a very street, dirty street, and then almost a broken house. There, in front of that house, he went and knocked the door and told Fagin, "Open the door. I have brought someone to you." So the door was open, and when Oliver got inside, he saw already there were 3-4 boys of his, almost of his age and older than him. All of them were sitting at a broken table. An old man, not exactly the old, but coming to the old age, he was preparing some sausages on the fire. So when he came inside, he sat, he saw people, there was no many furnitures inside the house. He was just sitting there. Now, when he sat there, the Fagin bought some food and all and gave him to eat. He just had it. And then Fagin opened a secret door from the wall and took out some jewelry, some handkerchief, costly handkerchiefs, and watches, golden watches. Oliver thought that if he is so rich, why he is living in such a bad condition? Then he thought maybe he is helping these children to for them for their food and lodging. That's why he is not having that much money. But then Fagin told Oliver that asked everybody that how who has bought things for me. Then when boy was there called Bat was there, Bates was there, Charlie Bates. He said that I bought four handkerchief and nylon, what you call, linen handkerchiefs. So Fagin said, yes, you are learning it. Then one by one everybody gave. Then he asked, Fagin asked Oliver, can you do this kind of things? And he said, of course, if you teach me, I will learn all these things. Then the boys started laughing and saying that, oh, don't worry, we are here to help you. So Oliver surprised why these people are laughing, hearing this. Then they all got together and Fagin dressed up like a gentleman, kept his things here and there in different pockets and said, okay, come on, you watch these people, how these people are doing things. So he went with them and started watching them. So one of the boys went in front of Fagin, stopped him, and other fellows came and took the things from him without his knowledge. Now seeing this, Oliver understood that they all are pickpockets. Now Oliver said to Fagin, told to Oliver, now it is your turn, you try to get this handkerchief without my feeling. Oliver said, okay, fine, I will do it. And he also took out the handkerchief without Fagin's knowledge. Fagin was very much surprised and shocked that he did so cleanly that Fagin did not come to know about it. So Fagin said, you will be a great person in this profession. And for a few more days he stayed there and worked with them, learned in learning, practiced with them. And after a few days he went with Dodger and Bate outside to pickpocket the people. So this is a story, friends. I hope you have understood the story well. Tomorrow I'll come back with your poem for the revision. Till then, stay home, stay safe, have a nice day.